Welcome to VSDc troubleshooting series. We've updated the project autosaving feature, so this quick tutorial will come in handy for both new and long-time VSDc users. For those of you who've never used it before, here's what the autosaving feature is for. If the power suddenly shuts down or the editor crashes, chances are the project you've been working on will be permanently lost. The autosaving feature is designed to prevent you from losing the project entirely. Now here is how to find it. In the top left corner, find Options and select Saving Options. You'll see a drop-down list where you can decide how often the program should save the input resources. Notice right below it we've added a new option called Number of Files for Auto-Saved Projects. The name of this option is quite self-explanatory. It determines the number of project copies created by VSDc when the auto-saving option is enabled. On the first saving, VSDc creates 5 identical copies of the project. By default, they are saved in the same folder as the main project file. They also have the same file extension type as the main file. If you want to learn more about the VSDc project file extension, check out this tutorial. Now, let's say you choose to save your project every 3 minutes. This is how it works. The program will subsequently replace created copies one by one. So after 15 minutes, you'll have 5 different versions of the project. And for each new project you create, VSDc will add a separate folder with the name of the project. That's all you need to know about the update. Before we wrap this up, we'll answer the most frequently asked question related to the autosaving feature, which is, why is it disabled by default? Well, for many of our users, it is simply not required. And for a large part of our audience who don't have enough space on their PCs, it can actually create a problem. But of course, if you're sure that your PC has enough space, your RAM is not overloaded, or you want to have several copies of the project, you can and should enable this option manually and adjust the number of copies. And that's all for today. We hope this tutorial was helpful. Leave a comment below if you have any questions, or let us know which feature you'd like us to talk about next.